City Contact is sponsored by Pete Chef.
Thank you very much.
Met a Tory woman, right, called Elizabeth Peacock, and she believes the way to stop crime is to publicly lash offenders live on the National Lottery. Don't go changing channel. We'll be picking the balls and whipping the balls after the break. Stay with us.
I have always had extremely strong views on sentences, and I sat as a magistrate from 1975, but I think we need even tougher sentences, because what we have now are many criminals, and particularly thugs, who cock a snoop. They know they're not going to get a very tough sentence, and therefore they don't care.
My name's Mark Thomas. I work for Channel 4. I am not a member of the liberal media elite. I have two questions to ask Mrs. Peacock. Firstly, you seem to be distancing yourself somewhat from the publicly birching people on the National Lottery, which I assume you alluded to. I personally don't see what is wrong with that. Surely it would be better to actually birch them on a programme that is shown earlier. A children's programme, so where they will see what will happen to them if they misbehave.
No, I'm not distancing myself to it. I believe somebody seeing that, it would have a deterrent effect.
I think if you are to actually target young children and to stop them before they commit crime, you need to be doing this on programmes like Blue Peter, where it will be seen. Now, this is a serious point. I think it should be done on Blue Peter, where it will be seen by young people, and it will deter them.
I think you have a very good point there.
You just think, what? What, they publicly beat young children live on British television? House of Commons completely empty. Every politician, kitchen table, plastic bag, satsuma in the mouth. And you know... that's a fact. That's why they can't bring back hanging. They bring back hanging half the cabinet, sniffing round the gallows. Can I borrow it for the weekend?
I think most people in this room are in agreement that we need capital punishment. And that what we need is to actually, to humiliate people and to actually embarrass them and to have a deterrent. And what I would suggest, and this may sound far-fetched, but I do think this is a worthwhile idea, is to actually bring back some form of crucifixion, because this is a public deterrent. This will stop people committing crime, and it's a public thing.
I mean, I think you're right, but I think that is perhaps even further to the right than I would be on this subject.
Right, I know a lot of people want the police to be heavily armed, and they're all going, give them guns, I don't have a problem with that, fuck it, give them the guns. You know, bullets, draw the line at, as they hurt. And I know the Royal Protection Squad have already got guns, but that's actually to keep the Royal Family in line. It is. That's Charlie, put your cock away. Diana, shut it. Who gave the Queen Mum matches? Come on, love, just stand there. What we should do is abolish the police sirens and make them play theme music from films. So you come out of the pub, 11 o'clock, 11:15, get in the car, drive off, suddenly behind you, little blue light. And if they ask you questions, we should make them play theme music and incidental music from television and radio. How long have you had this car then, sir? Biddy-diddy-diddly-diddy-boom! The thing is, people who run Britain actually believe that we live our lives like we're in an Ealing comedy. They actually think, what we'll do is we'll lock the buggers up and that'll teach them a lesson, yes? And they actually expect people to be coming out of places like Feltonham going, God blimey, Governor, 7 months of forced sodomy and drug abuse put me on a straight and narrow and no mistake.
Welcome to Britain's worst kept secret. Everyone in the world knows that this is MI6, apart from any officialdom, any Home Office, any Foreign Office, any Defence Office. None of them will admit that it's MI6. This beautiful Art Deco building behind me, is it MI6 or not? Because if it isn't, I actually want to get a flat there, because it looks very nice indeed. I feel like Roger Cook.
The MOD didn't find what we did very funny, and as a matter of national security, they forced us to cover up the identities of everyone in the piece.
Is this MI6? All it is everyone seems to know that it's MI6, apart from, well, the general public do, but there's no signs.
Could I ask you a question, please?
Yeah, sure.
Do you know what that building is over there?
Yeah, it's the MI6 building.
Can you tell us? You're not allowed to tell us.
This is
an
FCO building.
It's an FCO, which is...
Foreign Office.
Right. So it's Foreign Office building?
Yeah.
And is that all you can tell us?
Yeah.
So, I mean...
Well, that's all I need to know, surely.
Is it... Why is that?
Well,
I've
just told you what the building is.
Yeah, but you haven't told us what it's for.
Well, surely you know.
Well, I don't, but I want to know if you know.
Of course I know.
But you're not allowed to say.
Of course I have, I've told you.
Oh, have you told us already? I missed that.
Do you know what that building is?
Yes. It's the MI5 building.
That's MI5?
Yes. Yeah. Okay, no, we don't want photographs, guys. We don't want all that.
Do you know what who the building belongs to? Is it the Charles? No, but I mean, do you know, is it a spy? Are spies here?
It's a Foreign Office building.
Well, I know it's a Foreign Office building, but are there spies here?
No.
No, there's none here at all. You promise me?
It's a Foreign Office building.
Yeah, it's MI5.
Yeah, that's the MI5 building.
It's MI5.
MI5?
MI5 building.
It's MI5? Yeah. Could it be MI6?
No.
Can I leave this with you?
Of course.
Can I leave it? This is... Because I reckon you're not getting some posts. You see, that's a little sign there. If I could leave that, if you could give that to M? Or whoever? Just if you could pass it on. Because, you know, it hasn't got any... sign saying MI6.
Well, that's...
You could be getting all sorts of missives coming from spies all over the world.
Anyway.
Oh, do they?
Yes, we get no problems with that.
But you could have recruits who aren't getting in because they don't know where it is.
No problem.
Thank you very much for that. Cheers. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Thank you very much indeed. Can you tell us what the building is? We're absolutely 100% positive that this is definitely MI6. But just in case you might have a little bit of a memory lapse, we've got a little bit of a visual memory jog for you. Okay, boys. As you know, the Tory party are £15 million in debt. Hooray! Now, we're doing our little bit. We're collecting for a jumble. We're having a jumble later on. So we've got some incontinence pads that were sent in. There we are. Egg white for the Tory thumb. That was nice. I thought it was very... No, it's nice. There's a cheque for a quid and a canister of goat droppings. Remember, keep sending the stuff in because we're having the Torython jumble...